nuclear force. Here already we know the nuclei contains some of the components inside the nucleus, like protons and neutrons are present inside the nucleus. These protons and neutrons are present inside are called nucleons. To separate these nucleons from the constituent element, then we need energy. That energy is called binding energy. Here, why these protons and neutrons are binding inside the nucleus? That means here a strong force is acting between the nucleons. Here, the force which is acting between the nucleons is called nuclear force. The force which acts between the nucleons inside the nucleons inside the nucleus is called nuclear force. And this nuclear force is very strong force in the nature. When we compare it to the gravitational force and also Coulomb repulsive force. Here this Coulomb repulsive force is acting between the nucleus and also electron. And if we compare the force, magnitude of the force, then the nuclear force is very strong when comparing to this gravitational force and also the Coulomb repulsive force. And here the radius of the nuclei is in the terms of femtometers, If, for example, the radius of the nuclei is, that means the neutrons, that means nucleons and electrons, the distance is 0.8 femtometers, then only this nuclear force is acting between the nucleons and inside the nucleus. Now, for example, if the distance is 0.8 femtometers, greater than the 0.8 femtometers, then there is a attractive nuclear force is acting. If the value is less than 0.5 femtometers, then a strong repulsive force is acting. Here, a strong repulsive force is acting between the nucleons. If the distance is 0.8 femtometers, less than the 0.8 femtometers. If it is greater than 0.8 femtometers, then it is a attractive repulsive attractive nuclear force is acting. And this nuclear force is acting between the neutron-neutron or proton-proton or proton and neutron. Here, these are the different ways where the nuclear force is acting. And in these three situations also, the nuclear force is the same. The magnitude of the nuclear force is same. That means the nuclear force is not depending on the charge. The nuclear force is not depending on the charge. This is about a nuclear force. Here the nucleons are combined or bound together inside the nucleus. Here, these are bonding together into nucleus means there is a strong force is acting between the nucleus. That means here the strong nuclear force which acts between the nucleons is called nuclear force, and this is a very large force when comparing to this gravitational force and a Coulomb repulsive force. Here, if the distance between the nucleons is greater than 0.8 femtometers, then it is a attractive force. If the distance between the nucleons is 0.8 femtometers less than, then it is a repulsive force. There are three different ways: neutron-neutron, proton-proton and neutron-proton interactions. Then here the nuclear force is same for all these situations. That means the nuclear force is depending, is not depending on the charge of the particles. This is about a nuclear force. Now, radioactivity. This radioactivity is observed by the Henry Becquerel. Henry Becquerel in the year 1896. Here, this radioactivity observed by this Henry Becquerel, when this Henry Becquerel is observing the photo, fluorescence and phosphorescence. When he is observing and doing experiments on this fluorescence and photophosphorescence, then he observed this radioactivity. Here, when he is doing experiments with uranium sulfate, and this uranium sulfate is wrapped into the paper, is wrapped into the black paper and photographic plate. This photographic plate is wrapped into the silver, and these are wrapped into the black paper and this is wrapped into the silver, are placed separately inside a box. After so many hours, he found that this photographic plate is containing some black dots. That means here something is penetrate to this black paper and silver and forming on this photographic plate. Here, that means some matter is decayed and penetrate into this black paper and silver paper is found on this photographic plate. That's why now in this way he found this radioactivity. Radioactivity means here the elements or the nucleus decays into some other nucleus. This is called radioactivity. And this radioactivity having the units Becquerels. Here 1 Becquerel is equal to 1 disintegrations per second, or 1 decay per second. One more unit also we have for this radioactivity, that is a curie. Here this is a SA unit. Becquerel is the SA unit. And one more we have curie. Here this curie also we have one more unit. And this radioactivity we can observe naturally like 3 different ways. That is alpha decay and beta decay and gamma decay. Here in this alpha decay, generally the alpha particles, some nuclei are emitting the alpha particles, and in this beta decay the nuclei is emitting the electrons, and in this gamma decay it emits the radiations like photons. It emits the photons, and in the beta decay it emits the electrons, protons, positrons and neutrinos and antineutrinos. In the beta decay it emits the neutrinos and also positron. It emits the positron. Positron means which has same mass as the electron, but the charge is opposite to the electron. The charge is opposite to the electron. It's called positron. Now we are going to discuss about these alpha, beta and gamma decays. Now alpha decay.